Boys, finally, the Cars Drift Racing 3 has officially been released today for both Android and iOS. So today we are going to take some look. Once you enter the game, you'll be greeted with a good, home layout menu. And when you tap on the office section, you will see where you can, buy fans and, do some lot of things. So I can actually say that the interface is very good. The car customization is quite good. You can see the car you buy and, test how it feels, test the details in each of the cars you have purchased. So it's really cool. The sounds are really good, though, for me, actually. Ha ha ha. And I've tested, some details in it, and I gotta say that the details in this is cool, though. So after the game unique style makes it feel more lively than the previous CarX Drift 2. Now let us try some, few details in the game. So firstly, the game looks actually appealing as soon as you enter to play, and the camera settings are good. You can change from different camera angles to see, the perspective of how you want your view to be. And another thing is that you can also customize the camera angles in the settings, which I would show later. So the camera angles are quite good, but I would have loved to see it, having a 360 view. And this is because, as for now, we can only see from the rear view. So the settings are cool, though. You have a home button, which displays camera. And here, as I previously said, you can customize the camera angles you like to get the kind of view you like. And also I think the developers should also add the 360 view, very, very important. So the 360 view would be great to see here also. So the controls, the language and the graphics where you can set all that things, the music and everything look actually simple and user-friendly. So the CarX Drift 3 is actually a more better, upgraded version of, the car S Drift 2. So I can see that it actually looks cool. The drifting is quite, cool though, but it kind of seems the drifting is, kind of locked on automatically, kind of feeling like it's has automatically drifting assist. And also when you are drifting, the game tends, tends to be lagging. And at the moment, I'm using the iPhone 13 Pro Max to play. But it kind of seems it's still lagging and not that well optimized. So the Drift Racing 3 tends to be lagging when you are driving. And I'm not even capping, bro. Although CarX Street also faced this issue in the first release. So yeah, it's just a new game. So we could be expecting a more, update to fix some of the bugs and lagging issues in the game. Otherwise the game is quite good. The drifting is cool. But it also needs some optimization because when you're drifting, the game tends to be lagging. So the Car is Drift 3 is actually, a good game. And another downside of this game is, it seems to fully be run online, which means you will need a steady Wi-Fi connection to be able to get the smoother loading and changing in the game selections. And another issue many players are experiencing is that the game is not compatible with many players' devices. I mean, this has been the issue with CarX technology games. They make a game so realistic and superb that they forget that compatibility issues would decrease the download amount of the game, since the numbers of players using high-end devices is very low. So I think CarX technology needs to work more on the compatibility of their games, because a lot of players are having issues playing the game, and even the ones that can play it still finds it lagging. Otherwise the game is really good. And we also hope for future improvements. So guys, what are you having any issues with the CarX Drift 3? Let me know in the comment section and make sure to also subscribe for more videos. Thanks, and see you in the next one.